Nilo, do you know what the Karnak Temple in the Luxor, Egypt is? It is a temple complex that was originally built around 1950 BC, followed by 5 centuries of no addition. According to the Wall Street Journal, it is among the most popular tourist attractions in Egypt due to its immense size. I'm here to discuss facts about its history and architecture. With information about the history of the complex, architectural components of the site, and the studies that were being done by archaeologists to understand the inscriptions. Like I said, the first phase was begun around 1950 BC. And then during the 18th dynasty, beginning in 1550, Karnak became a symbol of power and wealth with the addition of temples and other architectural details. Growth was interrupted under the rule of Akhenaten when a temple was built under his rule to block the sun rays to the Karnak Temple. Even under Greek and Roman rule, small temples were added to the complex, including the Temple of Osiris under Roman rule. Next, I will discuss the architectural components of the temple, including the temples featured in the complex, the Great Hypostyle Hall, and the pylons of the Karnak Temple complex. Here's an ancient view of the temple, and here's a modern view.
You went too far,
it was accident.
It's okay. Here, I'll get it back.
Some of the architectural components. It covers the northern half of what was once the city of Thebes and is still impressive, even though nothing remains of the homes, palaces, and gardens that used to surround Karnak. The Temple of Amon itself features 10 pylons that are separated by courts and a hall, with pylons 1 through 6 forming an east-west axis toward the Nile River. The remaining pylons form a series of processional gateways at right angles toward the main axis that link the Temple of Mut at Karnak and the Luxor Temple 2 miles away. The Hypostyle Hall is the most impressive feature seen at the Karnak Temple ruins, and it occupies the space between the second and third pylons. The area covered by this great hall is 54,000 square feet, and 1,280-foot columns support the roof slabs of the central main and it was positioned above the rest to allow light to and air to enter through a clear story. The Great Temple of Amon features other notable smaller shrines and temples within its walls. These include temples dedicated to Ptah under Hatshepsut and Thutmose III, and the temples of Khonsenopet built under the reign of Ramses II. This right here is the Great Hypostyle Hall at Karnak, in the Temple of Amon. Finally, I will be discussing the work that has been done by Egyptologists to understand the writings inscribed in the walls. Deciphering the walls that carved the Karnak Temple with a large number of religious texts and images was a difficult and massive project that was made even more urgent with the wind and sun chipping away at its markings. Further complicating matters, the decoration in the Hypostyle Hall is highly inconsistent, and this reflects the work that has been changed over time by different pharaohs such as Ramses II. However, enough of the Karnak Temple survives to get an idea about ancient Egyptian religious life, and the inscriptions provide information about the premise on building ancient Egyptian society. Today we have discussed the Karnak Temple in Luxor, Egypt, and covered the history of the temple, the architectural components making up the complex, and the work that is being done by archaeologists to understand the inscriptions there. It has an older foundation, though with much of it being constructed during the 18th dynasty, and is a fine example of ancient Egyptian religious architecture. And here's the inscription on the wall. Thanks for your time.